Our next guest is one of the most dominant players on the basketball court, shattering records across the world. Check her out.
Liz Cambage is a superstar in the world of basketball, taking on America at their own game and slam dunking her way to greatness. In fact, she was the first woman to slam dunk at an Olympic Games. But sporting prowess isn't all she's got. She's a fashion icon and professional DJ to boot. Please welcome Liz Cambage. Woo!
I'm definitely far from shy. I was just laughing at myself taking selfies. That's my number one hobby.
Oh, sensational. Hey, congratulations.
Oh, thank you.
How are you feeling at the moment?
Good. I feel really good. I've just had a summer at home, actually, due to injury, but it's been so nice being home and spending time with my family and friends.
Wow.
Yeah.
What is it like being at the top of your game internationally and having that record of a first slam dunk at an Olympic Games and writing yourself into the record books like that?
I tend to forget. Like, it's on my resume, but it's not something I really am looking at and talking about every day. I'm lucky most of my friends back home have no idea what I actually do. They know I go overseas for 4 to 5 months to China or to America and, you know, play a bit of basketball, but they don't really get what the athlete life is about, and I think that's why I love my friends so much. They're just oblivious to my actual lifestyle, but...
Keep you grounded.
Yeah, grounded.
That's beautiful, though.
You, in America, especially, it is, you know, basketball's so huge. You have been very outspoken on the inequality in sport. Tell me more.
Yeah, I think I'm just very vocal about, you know, inequality and diversity and everyday life. I grew up in a household where my mum is a CEO and, you know, I listened to her and, you know, talk to what she had to deal with in boardrooms every day. And, you know, I didn't really realise how different it was for women in this world until, you know, I left high school and entered the real world. So, yeah, especially in sport, you know, in basketball, there's such a big difference in our, you know, our pay gap at the moment, and it's something we're fighting for over in America.
But how do you deal with it?
How do we deal with it? Well, you got to take it day by day. You know, we get given mountains to fight ourselves, and this is a one battle I've taken on myself. You know, I could easily not be vocal and could just do my thing every day, but I want better for, you know, our future athletes, for our future women in any career that they choose to, you know, pursue.
Recent.
Sorry, you go. You would have been very encouraged by the weekend results with the AFL women.
Yes.
A huge, not only, you know, people going to the game and making a real spectacle, but the viewing audience had more than doubled on last year. It's unusual to see that kind of exponential growth. So that's obviously certain sports and certain areas are kind of increasing, aren't they?
Yeah, it's great. And, you know, not the other sports have the same funding and, you know, media reach as the AFL. But I love, you know, Erin Phillips is a great friend of mine. She's actually assistant coach in the WNBA. I've, you know, played with her for years, basketball for Australian Opals, and, you know, I'm so sad that she did ACL on the weekend, but I'm sending her lots of love and a fast recovery.
Wow. Recently, the AFL Women's League player Taylor Harris had that terrible trolling incident after that magic photo of her went everywhere. Have you said you don't mind doing a selfie. have you experienced any of that sort of trolling that she's gone through?
I thought you were going to ask me to do a selfie while doing
second part of the question.
Look, I'm pretty flexible, but I don't think I could get it that high. It's such a powerful image. When I heard I actually had a reporter call me and ask me for some comments on it, and I was like, I'm sorry, I'm so out of the loop. I don't even know what's happening, so I can't give you any information. But I just saw everyone joining in and doing their take on the photo. But when I found out about it, at the end of the day, the trolls come from usually men who are very insecure in their own lives and project their insecurities out on the internet. It's very hard for them to see women in sport, women getting paid to do something they probably dreamt to do.
Well, I can tell you, I used to play a bit of junior AFL, and seeing that kick, I was envious. That is absolutely clinically textbook.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it's great. If they've got insecurities with it, then screw them.
At the end of the day, trolling is people just projecting their own insecurities. And I'm lucky, in a way. I was bullied since primary school.
For your height?
For everything. Being, you know, I didn't really understand why I was being bullied for being a different colour. You know, I grew up in a white household. My mum and my grandma are white, and I didn't really understand why I was different. I didn't see myself as different. Mm. It's kind of like having a dog in the family. They think they're human, you know? I thought I was just another white girl, but it wasn't until I moved to America I realised how different and diverse I was, and how, you know, I really didn't have anyone to look up here in Australia. Mm. And I guess that's why I recently joined Dove and Getty and Girl Gaze on this new project called Show Us.
Mm. Which is about body image.
Which is about body image and fighting for diversity in media and advertising.
Because mm-hmm. the whole yeah. body image thing, mm. what we know as young women grow, mm-hmm. I mean, it's been mm-hmm. on forever, mm. but mm-hmm. more focused because of Instagram, mm. because of all this mm-hmm. sort of stuff now. And it is more important for women to be proud of exactly mm-hmm. who they are. How do you portray that then?
Yeah, you know, growing up for me was so hard. I had no one who was different to look up to. You know, Australia isn't the most diverse place when it comes mm. to media and advertising, and I literally had no one to look at on TV other than Beyonce and Rihanna, mm. and I definitely do not look like either of those amazing women, but I think that's why I'm so proud of myself, and I want to be a role model for girls who are different and have no one to look up to, because when I go do camps at schools and I train these beautiful Indian or African or Asian girls and who have no one to look up to, I just want everyone to know that they are beautiful the way they are and that there's a place for them here.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
What did your mum say when you were being bullied at school? You'd come home and what would you say to her and how would she respond?
My mum would always tell me I was the most special, beautiful girl in the whole world, that I was her little bird, and, you know, one day I'll find my wings and I will fly. And, you know, I'm flying now, and I left home when I was 16 to start my career, and, you know, I love my mum so much. I couldn't have done it without her having my back the whole time, and yeah, no matter what issues or what social media battle I'm in one day, she's always got my back.
Isn't that cool? And you've also been, you mentioned you're off with the injury and we're talking about body image. How hard is it for you when you're injured and you can't play? Mm. What effect does that have on
it
you?
It really messes with your head. Like a couple of weeks ago I was having a moment because I haven't run since end of September wow. last year. When I got home from the World Champs, my physio told me I wasn't really allowed to do much. I had to stay. I hurt my Achilles, tendonitis and wow. bursitis at the same time. Ooh. And she sat me down and was like, I don't want you walking wow. for a good month. Like, you wow. need complete time off. And especially being an athlete, what work am I meant to go do? I dropped out of fashion school. I never really got any degrees. I can't mm-hmm. go get a job working somewhere. I have to stay off my feet and rest myself and do my rehab. Ooh. So what... How are we looking after our athletes when they do get injured?
Good point.
You do have a fallback though, don't you? Like, I mean, because my mum said to me, why don't you get a trade just in case show business doesn't work out? Kids don't get a trade, show business always works out. But you're pretty good on the wheels of steel. You're doing a bit of DJing. This is your fallback position, yeah? You can be a DJ?
Yeah.
Yeah?
I do a little bit. I actually have a gig coming up this weekend.
Great, look at that. Wheels of steel.
That's me doing my thing. Dylan Alcott's festival weekend, Ability Fest in Melbourne on Sunday. You can actually catch me DJing out there, and it's such a sick lineup. If you're in Melbourne, buy tickets. And then next Monday, I'm off to Coachella to DJ a few private parties.
Congratulations.
Hello.
Awesome. Well, nice little side job there. Yeah. But while I was injured, I was meant to stay off my feet, so I couldn't do that. But I'm back and about and, back running around.
Great Coachella, work. Man. I like Dylan's gig is going to be amazing. That leads us to the Tokyo Olympics.
Yes.
Are they in your sights?
Oh, definitely. That's literally the top of the pyramid right now that I'm chasing, and it will be my third Olympics, and I want a big sparkly medal. I came home with it.
So you can put it on Instagram.
Well, I got a bronze in London Olympics. Yep. Came home very sadly empty-handed from Rio, and that's just made me hungrier.
Yeah.
Right. So I'm ready to get something very shiny in Tokyo next year.
Okay, what's the route of training to get to that point? The pinnacle of it, how do you get there?
We have an amazing coach, Sandy Brondello, and she's a head coach of the Phoenix Mercury in the WNBA. So she spends all year watching us and scouting us and putting together the team, and we have small group training sessions in between seasons. Mm. And, It's up to the coach. So, hey, Sandy, working hard.
Big sparkly medal. Just make sure you you ease up on the ACL, right? Or is it the
Achilles. No ACL.
Oh, gosh.
No ACL.
Sorry, I should never have said that.
You touched point.
You're going to be fine, sister. What a role model you are. Gorgeous woman. Thank you so much for stopping by our little morning show.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you.